All right. Cool. Scoot up. All right, so I was working on Cold Inside. Just the verses. So let me just pull that up quick. Starts right around here. I had it tuned down, so let me go ahead and tune that back up to normal. Here we go. Okay, so that's about the focus, right? And the first thing to notice is that the melody is pretty much the same for every phrase of the four. And when you transcribe it on guitar, it goes something like this. Now, there's a little, there's an approximation. I think I missed a couple of those up. And listening to it now, let me just listen to this last phrase again. Yep, so just go down there. I thought it maybe it sat on the F sharp. So the guitar is in drop D tuning. Though the song has kind of a sad feel to it, it's actually a D major. All right, so it's kind of doing like, and that's really where you get your sad feel. It's that B flat E D sound. You could think of that keeps that D in the bass there. So that's the verse guitar part right there. And so what I was doing was I was taking really just one phrase at a time. So this. And within that, even to my ears, it kind of has a two-part thing. So like the cold on cold, let's see. So cold on and then the inside. And the reason for that is the melody going. That feels like the first part to me. So, cold on, and then you go the inside, right? Cold on the inside, and so that kind of is how I break it down in even the smaller chunks. Then I go cold on, cold on, cold. Then listen back to his vocal. He's got kind of that. There's a softest, but still full. So it's like a speaking voice, but with a bit of a longing to it. So cold on, cold on the inside. And by the way, at first I didn't actually get that pickup, that F sharp to A. I just thought it was instead of for that first phrase. So, cold on the inside. So there's a lot of nuance in there, which is nice to, on repeated listens, you start picking those things up, which is the nice thing about really focusing in on a small section. All right, so just jumping in now to if I was just practicing it, let me just demonstrate how that would look. So I already chunked out just the one phrase of the four. So my first step is to figure out what that melody is. So I'll just kind of sing it. Cold on the inside. And then on my guitar. So now I know what that is. And it may take longer than that, obviously, to figure out the melody on your instrument. But I already did, so I get to kind of cheat. And it's not that much. Once you figure out the first note, the following notes, they fall into place pretty quickly. So cold on. So now what I'm looking for is kind of an approximation of his timbre, of his voice. So what do we got? Cold on, cold on the inside. Cold on the inside. So for the record, I'm not warmed up on vocals or guitar, so bear with me here. All right, and so once I feel like I've got something going there, I'm just gonna throw the actual guitar part in there. Cold on the inside. And then really just sit on that. Cold on the inside. Cold on the inside. Cold. What's nice about this is that you can really slow it down as much as you need. So the goal here is to be able to sing the melody without having to think too hard about what's coming next, which is just a matter of repetition. It's just like learning a lick on a guitar. If I had to think about constantly what was coming next, then I'd get in a real performance scenario that would I'd get lost in that. So same thing here, and that's where the small chunks, repeating them, and one of the added benefits here too with a repeated melody like this is once you get the first chunk, the following chunks are going to come much easier. But I'd still say spend plenty of time in them because the reinforcing, 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 you're never gonna go wrong with that. So cold on the inside. And once you've done it a few times, listen back. You might feel yourself losing it, like losing the feel, the vibe, the tone. Cold on, cold on, cold on the inside. Cold on the inside. Cold on. Cold on the inside. All right, so that'd be that phrase. Yeah, so I just kind of move on to the next one. Take this chunk. Let's kind of shorten that chunk just a touch. All right, so, and of course, it can help to write the lyrics out. I probably will. I haven't done it yet, but especially in a case of a song with subtle little changes like this one, where if you listen to the song, the first and second verse, actually, I'll just demonstrate. The first and second verse, they're very, very similar. I'll go phrase by phrase here. But there's little variations in the actual lyrics, which is a very Jay, the songwriter, Jay thing to do.
Cold on the inside.
Okay, so sorry, that was verse one, and this is verse two. First phrase of verse two.
Cold on the inside.
other than that in the way he sang in on that one, it's like you could have think that was a copy-pasted take. It was so similar, but the in was a little bit different. The pitch on it was a little different. So then this is the second phrase of verse one.
In phases, my lights died.
So in phases, my lights died. And then in verse two, you get.
In faces, a smile dies.
In faces, the smile dies. So really similar, right? Like just the sounds, but very different line. And then the third line here, verse one.
Staring through ardent eyes.
Staring through ardent eyes. And verse two.
Staring through ardent eyes.
Same thing, staring through ardent eyes. And again, you can hear the subtle differences. So an ardent in this one is where it really pops out to me. He hits it a lot harder in the second verse. Let me just pull it. So this is verse two. That R, and then in verse one here, it's very soft, right? So his tone is very, very close, but you pick up these little differences. And then the last line of verse one. I love you, but I lie or lied. I'm not sure how the tale on that one is. Could be either. The meaning's the same, more or less. And then in verse two, you get. I loathe you, but I lie. So the first one's I love you, and then I loathe you. So yeah, writing down lyrics can help you keep track of those little changes. All right, so if we take the second phrase of verse one.
In phases, my lights die.
So in phases, in fa and there's a little pickup. And does that I think it's that low A. And he's not really voicing this one. It's just like a kind of like a grunt. In phases, my lights die. In phases, my lights die. So let's get the tone here. In phases, in phases, my light. In phases, my lights die. So I'm feeling some strain in my voice. I'm doing something. I'm pushing too hard now, but it's because I'm thinking too much.
In phases.
In phases, in phases, my lights die. In phases, my lights die. So the first number of times I might play through this phrase, maybe I'll slow it down. So it'll be like, well, okay, so first, obviously, I'll play along with the guitar. In phases, my lights die. In phases, my lights die. And in this phase, doing this, I'll often check the timbre.
In phases.
In phases.
In phases.
In phases. He's got a little bit of nasality going. In phases. In phases, my lights die. 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 All right, so. And just keep that one going. Again, it's just go. Relax into it. Just like sit on one phrase, sit with it, repeat it, and just kind of vibe with it. No pressure to move on to the next phrase. Just really get comfortable with that one. And I find it to be a lot more fun that way, strangely enough. Like, I would have thought if someone told me to do that, that it would be like, oh, I'm gonna be doing one line over and over and over, and it's gonna be really boring. But there's so much to explore within that one line, with the timbre, with the pitches, with the phrasing, and just really getting comfortable with the lyrics and the melody, that there's plenty to think about, there's plenty to do. Like, you don't need to overload it. All right, so let's jump to the third one.
Stirring through all night.
So this is the most significant melody change. Not much going on. It's not really doing that pickup from the previous line, the in day. It's doing staring through, but instead of that kind of slide up, it just hits the next note, the next higher note. Through ah, instead of through ah, right? It's through ah, din as, instead of ah, it hits that twice. Din as, ah, din as. So, staring through all the night.
Stirring through.
Through.
Stirring through.
Through.
Stirring through all.
Just that light. I'm trying to capture that kind of lightness of the higher notes. Through all the night. Staring through all the night, staring through all the night, staring through all the night, staring through all the night. You know, and just that on repeat again, always double checking with the timbre, trying to. I never sing along with him because I can't check myself or I can't check. The recording while I do that, and it's like wasted time, right? Once I figure out the notes, I can sing along to the guitar. Staring through all the night, and I can always kind of check his timbre, go back and check that, and try to approximate it with my own voice. But I'm not gonna really get that from singing along with him. I'm just gonna be lost in the mix, right? And it's not going to help my pitch accuracy too much either. So, staring through all the night. And just making sure that on every note you sing, you can feel it's not a lot of strain. It's relaxed. And if you are feeling strain, that's a great time to go back and reference the timbre of the recorded singer. Because chances are, if they're decent at all and got any technique at all, then they're going to be pretty relaxed. And so, if you can approximate their sound, you're going to be working towards a healthier sound and a more relaxed sound. All right, jump into the last line. And this is going to be, I love you, but I lie.
I love you, but I lie.
Lie. So, there's a really quick lie at the end there. So it's again that pickup, and that kind of guttural. It's not really even saying I. It's like that like a vocal fry kind of sound. I love you, but I lie. That quick one, lie. I love you, but I lie. And you kind of hold that one out. La la la. I'm not using good rest support there, so it's a little bit hard, but let's just try the full thing. Love you, but I lie. Love you, but I love you.
But I love you, but I lie. I love you, but I lie. I love you, but I lie.
extended on this last phrase. It does, the guitar part changes to. Where it just kind of holds out on that a bit longer. So let's try it. I love you, love you, but I lie. I love you, but I lie. I love you, I love you, but I lie. I love you, but I lie. And slow it down a bit. I love you, but I lie. 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 So I noticed when I was going through learning these phrases, and I still am practicing them, it was the time I would get lost a lot. I'd want to do like skip that in the melody, so I'd go, I love you, but I, but I, but I, instead of but I, but I, but I. And I also catch myself having the most strain around here, which is where it really helps to just kind of jump in, even just partway through the phrase, to just pick up that. But I love you, but I love you, but I lie. 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 To that, we're kind of jumping beyond the scope of the verse one, but it's just a tiny little intermission part.
Yeah.
It's just really soft. So that's about that. Peace.